Now I will go ahead and install the steering servo here at front of the car, as shown on this picture. So for this, I will leave the camera servos, the PTZ servos, in place, connected. They should not be interfering too much. Pick the servo, and now first we have to figure out how it should fit in this square opening here. The servo has to be installed with the cable pointing toward the front of the robot and the shaft also located closer to the front of the robot, like this. For the installation, I will use two M2x8 bolts. I'll take two of them from the back. Put the rest aside, and I will need two corresponding M2 nuts for the bolts. Take two of them. And leave the rest aside. According to the instruction, I'm supposed to put the bolts from the top. I will start with the bolt closer to the Raspberry Pi. And place nut on the bottom. Tighten loosely. Pick a second bolt, insert at the front from the servo side through the holes, through the chassis. Place a nut. And now I can go ahead and start tightening. If necessary, I can use the little wrench, but I don't think in this case this will be necessary. Yes, I am able to tighten the servo quite well without the help of the wrench. So the servo is mounted and it will actually look very similar to what's shown on the second picture. This step is completed. Now I'll go ahead and mount the servo horn with this steering part here. It's some kind of steering rod, arm or something. I'll connect, basically install the horn on the servo shaft. So I'll go ahead, pick the parts. The servo is already centered in previous step. I'll be careful not to rotate the shaft. Rotate the horn to point toward the front of the car, like this. Try my best to make it exactly oriented in the general axis of the car. Carefully press, holding with another finger here the servo itself, not to exert force on the chassis, and make sure it is fully inserted. The horn is fully inserted. Next, pick the back of parts from the same servo. Take out the little bolt the very small boat. From the back, this boat is intended to hold, to tighten into the servo shaft and to hold the servo horn or arm in place. Place it into the thread in the center of the shaft and tighten. Don't worry that the shaft will rotate at this point. Our horn is already inserted properly, so this is not a problem. And this part is properly assembled and looks exactly as shown in the picture. This step is completed. Now I'll go ahead, skip this step and directly go and assemble this part. I will do this step after that, since having this part ready will help me experimenting with this, properly assembling this step. So for this step I'll need this part that holds effectively big part of the steering mechanism. Four of these brass standoffs, they are M3x25 standoffs and four M3 nuts for the standoffs. So go ahead, take out the standoffs, four of them, put the rest aside. Take four nuts. Put the last side. Pick this part. It appears to be fully symmetric, so I can mount it anywhere I want. I have to mount the standoffs in these four holes. So go ahead, insert a standoff, the mail thread of one of the standoffs, through a hole. Put in it and tighten. For now I'll tighten loosely. I prepared the wrenches, but I will not be using them in this step, as I want these standoffs to be a little bit loose to be able to adjust them properly if necessary when tightening the other side. Then I'll go ahead and tighten all of the threads when everything is in place. Repeat the same procedure with another standoff. Insert from the same side. Once when you have picked a side for the standoffs, always insert the standoffs from the same side. Put a nut and loosely tighten so the standoff will be held in place. Not too loose, but still being able to slightly adjust if needed. Continue with the next one. Put the nut. And the final one. And the nut. This step is completed and this part looks exactly as shown on the picture. Now I'll go ahead and effectively follow these three steps. They're closely connected, so following them together pretty much will be quite easy. They're all related with assembling the steering wheels, this part of the steering mechanism, and the chassis. They all have to fit together. So the first step is to figure out how it all should fit together. We have to pay attention to the first picture. As you can see, we have this part of the steering mechanism, which is effectively steering arm, if I'm not mistaken. And it has to fit in such a way that these two pins will fit into this and this part here, with this one fitting here. This part pointing downwards should fit into this steering arm, and the same should happen with the other wheel. Now, when I tested before recording the video, I noticed that they fit in those holes extremely tight and even may damage slightly the holes. For this reason, I have picked a small filler, and I would recommend you to do the same. And now I will just lightly scrape very, very small fraction of millimeter, just the corners, so to smooth the corners of these parts. Then I will connect and check the fit. The same thing with these corners here. This will serve two purposes. First of all, it will make fitting easier, and second, should help with smoother operation. And we go and do the same here. I'm just using a flat filler. Just slightly smoothing the corners. Now let's test. This one fits very, very nice and smooth now. This one fits very smooth as well. And finally, this one fits perfectly fine. So smoothing the corners, and again, you can use other file, or you can use a knife or screwdriver or scissors to slightly rub off the corners to smoothen them. The reason for the tight fit is most likely that the corners are obviously not very smooth. And again, rub very, very little, just to smooth the corner, a very, very small fraction of the millimeter. It doesn't take much. Each of the four corners. And again, you can use any type of tool to smoothen them. Okay, now let me test that this guy will fit in all of the holes. Fits into this one. Fits into this one. And finally, still a bit tight fit. So this one needs a little bit loosening. Okay, now it fits. Yeah, so nice and dandy. So now I can go ahead. This is, by the way, the reason I wanted this part assembled. It's much easier to get them all together at once. So place this one like this, with this part pointing toward the front of the robot. Make sure you're picking the right wheel, right? So this is the wheel for the other side. This is the correct wheel for this side. Place this one here and this one into this hole. Leave it like this. As you can see, it's a bit loose. Don't worry. It all will be straightened once when we place this part in place. Now rotate, carefully not to drop it. Repeat the same for this side. This one going here and the other one here. Like this. So this wheel is like this and this wheel like this. And now pick this part, consult briefly. Yes, it should be mounted in such a way that this is pointing toward the front of the robot. So it will be connected in these four holes here. Place the wheel into the hole. Repeat the same with the other wheel. As you can see, it fits exactly in this hole here. Now the wheel should be properly secured in place. Pick four M3x8 bolts. Hold this part in place, flip over, insert a bolt into the corresponding hole, into the standoff, and loosely tighten. Now go ahead and do with diagonal standoff. Now best to go to this one to hold as early as possible this wheel. And the final standoff. And starting with this one, we can start fully tightening. Now that everything is in place, I can also use this wrench and tighten everything from top to bottom. If you remember, in the previous steps we left these nuts not fully tightened. Now I can go ahead and tighten everything completely. This step is completed, and as you can see, now our robot car has steering wheels.